additives in polymer films perform a plethora of tasks. This is our sample, one of four raw polymer films taken straight from the production line. To prepare them for a micro FTR measurement, we took the four samples, each with a different amount of UV absorber, cut them into thin strips, and mounted them on the microscopy sample holder. This sample holder is then inserted into the LUMOS II, and a visual overview image of the entire sample area is captured for reference. From left to right, we have films with 0, 1, 2.1 and 3.5% of UV absorber content. So, we would expect that the FTR signals get stronger from left to right. Let's put that assumption to the test. To verify these values qualitatively, we set 4 to 5 measurement points on each film by clicking on the region of interest. If needed, the measurement points can be adjusted after placing them. We enter the name of the sample and start the measurement. The system then automatically records the FTR spectra at the respective positions. Due to the sample thickness, the CH bands of the base polymer pass into total IR absorption. However, this is not a problem because these bands do not interfere with the comparatively small signal of the UV absorber. After having normalized all spectra to equalize any layer thickness offset, we can integrate the frequency range of the UV absorber peak and view the result. The scale on the right provides information about the relative intensity. White or red means a high relative concentration, blue or green, a low concentration. As expected, from left to right, the concentration increases. So far, so good. However, we can do much more with IR microscopy. Assuming that the reference values given for each film are correct, we can use them to build a method that quantifies the UV absorber content of any polymer film within the same concentration range. First, we create an average spectrum from the measurement point of each film. Then we take the average spectra and enter the respective UV absorber percentage for each sample, select the appropriate frequency range in the IR spectrum corresponding to the UV absorber content, and save the method to our hard drive. The program Opus now displays the calibration curve and an acceptable correlation coefficient of about 0.99. That's about it. Now we can apply the method to our measurement. On the right side, the scale has now changed and the value directly show the UV absorber percentages. The colors of the measurement points also correspond to this. Now the method allows us to assess the content of any polymeric film at a single glance. But if we combine this method with focal plane array imaging, it can do even more for us. To demonstrate, we defined an area of about 3.2 by 3.2 millimeters on one of the polymer films. Again, the system automatically collects the data. And when we apply our previously created method, we can quantify the distribution of UV absorber in the material in one sweep. In this case, the content doesn't change too much throughout the film and remains about 3.5%. However, FTIR imaging reveals that the production process has left fine streaks or lines with slightly lower concentration in the material. This is exactly the type of information about a sample that can provide decisive impulses for process optimization or troubleshooting, making FTIR a mighty tool for quality control and development of polymer materials. Thanks for watching, and for more information, check out the video description.